body of Helena with the holy water that recalls her baptism, of which St. Paul writes, all of us who are baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were buried together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection.
And on this morning,
It is good for us to be here together today. We come without words, but we come with great love and prayer for Helena's family. It is very different today, and trying to find adequate expressions for what's going on today in Jody's life and the life of the children and the parents. Only God knows that we're here silently just to assure them that in the most difficult of hours in their life, that they're not alone. That we're here to pray with them, to love them. And even though we do not physically sympathize with them, nevertheless, our very presence is an assurance to them that even though it's the darkest of days, that we are there, but above all, to reassure them that our God is forever present to them. As we reflect on, and as we find some way to adequately express to ourselves and to each other how we might have been in some way affected by Helena's life, at this time the family members will bring forward some symbols of her life to kind of enable us to reflect and to maybe smile and to laugh at some of the things that meant so much to her. So could I invite the family members at this time to bring forward the gifts.
O'Sheen brings a family picture. Helena loved family days out, especially on Sundays. The family would head away out early in the morning and not getting back until late in the evening. Katie brings a photo of her nieces and nephews. Helena loves spending time with them. She was always on hand to lend support or offer advice when it was needed. Oren brings Helena's phone. Helena loved being able to chat with family and friends, especially her friend Mary. She also loved her WhatsApp group, Ellen. This was a group of Helena's former work colleagues from Limerick who she kept in touch with. Helena enjoyed being a part of this group and being able to stay in touch with her family and their lives. Lastly, Bevin brings Helena's tote bag, which she purchased just a few short weeks ago. She loved this bag with her name on it. Helena loved shopping and she was always mad for a bargain. When Helena went shopping, and if she came across something that she thought any of us would like, she would send a picture. You would never go shopping for a day with Helena and not get a bargain. She had a great eye for fashion.
She didn't just buy a bag, she brought a sack. Honest to God, I think it was like Santa Claus. These items truly reflect who Helena was, and indeed will bring memories and joys to the family forever and ever. And so we come together today prayerfully. We begin this celebration of life in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let's take a moment to acknowledge that we are in the presence of our God, the God who gave Helena life, sustained her throughout her life, and indeed calls her to himself at this time. Lord Jesus, you raised the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the wayward sinner. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you give light to those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, you made the union of husband and wife a sign of the bond between Christ and his church. Grant peace and mercy to Helena, who was united in love with her husband, Jody. May the care and devotion of her life here on earth find a lasting reward in heaven. Look kindly on Jody and on the family as now they turn to your compassion and love. Strengthen their faith and lighten their loss. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated as we listen to the scripture readings. The family members have chosen some selections from the scriptures which are meaningful to them. I invite the readers, please come forward.
First reading. There is a season for everything, a time for every occupation under heaven, a time for giving birth, a time for dying, a time for planting, a time for uprooting what has been planted, a time for killing, a time for healing, a time for knocking down, a time for building, a time for tears, a time for laughter, a time for mourning, a time for dancing, a time for throwing stones away, a time for gathering them up, a time for embracing, a time to refrain from embracing, a time for searching, a time for losing, a time for keeping, a time for throwing away, a time for tearing, a time for sowing, a time for keeping silent, a time for speaking, a time for loving, a time for hating, a time for war, a time for peace. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We want you to be quite certain, brothers, about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them like other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will be the same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. We can tell you this from the Lord's own teachings, that any of us that are left alive until the Lord's coming will not have any advantage over those who died. At the trumpet of God, the voice of the archangel will call out the command, and our Lord will come down from heaven. Those who have died in Christ will be the first to rise, and those of us who are still alive will be taken up to the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as these, you should comfort one another. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the proud, "All that the Father gives me will come to me, and whoever comes to me, I shall not turn him away, because I have come from heaven, not to do my own will, but to do the will of the one who sent me. Now the will of him who sent me is that I should lose nothing of all that he has given to me, that I should raise it up on the last day. Yes, it is my Father's will that whoever sees the Son and believes in him shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You know, life is strange, and you know, we think we know all about life, and it doesn't take much to dislocate us from our journey in life every so often. And there is somewhat of a false theory going around that if we live in old age. And we get our names in the papers every so often. And we're very good at some things. And if we make our name known for ourselves in the community, society's philosophy is that these are important people. Just because they've accomplished something, or they were good on the football field, or they did something in their lifetime, they lived to be a ripe old age. That's how society today seems to measure, as it were, the value of a person's life. And yet, you know, we have no evidence whatsoever from the Word of God, from the Scriptures, that this is what a successful person is. We think that old age and so forth is a reward for being good, but it isn't. You know, we all know that we've been given life by God, and that we all have a purpose in life, and that nobody was ever born into this world without a God-given purpose. We all have charisms and gifts in abundance. Sometimes those gifts are wasted. Sometimes they go unnoticed. But we all are in the drama of life. And if I could get rid of that sound and the microphone, it would be much, much better. That's one way of getting rid of it. But we're all on the stage every day of our lives, and when we've performed our part, so to speak, we move off center, off to the side. Some people have been enabled by the grace of God and their own efforts that they are, you know, they feel that they can be done without, but that's not true either. And so, you know, we all have these talents and gifts given to us to be harnessed and utilized for the common good of all, not for any private individual benefits, but for the common good of all. And we're all indispensable in the eyes of God. And we are still creating the world with His grace, working together. Some people, it takes a whole lifetime of 70 or 80 or 90 years of age to accomplish the responsibilities and the tasks that God has given to them. Some people do it in a very short period of time. In other words, they affect the world for good. They bring about wholesomeness and goodness into the world. Helena it only took her 39 years to accomplish her God-given task. And what was that God-given task? It was indeed to make Christ's presence and Christ's love known not just within the confines of her own family, but indeed to her colleagues, her friends, to all of us. We're all here today in some way trying to, even by our very presence, to say thank you to Helena for having indeed enriched the lives of each and every one of us in a very, very short time. The symbols that the kids brought up in the beginning of Mass today was a kind of an indication of how Helena responded to the call of Christ to be his instrument in the world. And when we ever talk of Jesus Christ, the first thing we think of is his great commandment, and that is to love as he loved. In other words, to love until it hurts, to love until it kills us. Just in imitation of the Lord himself, who gave and gave and gave and gave again until he had nothing more to give. Helena, up to the last almost moments of her life, followed that example of Jesus Christ himself. She gave and she gave until she couldn't give anymore. She gave because she was overflowing with love, that she was truly a visible instrument of God's love in the world, especially and in particular to Jody, to her three children, to her parents, not many of us were so organized in our lives as she was, to the point of she arranging her own funeral, basically. None of us have that love. And to behold the love between Jody and herself, it was unique. As you know very well, Jody, yourself. And you know that her one concern in leaving this world is, would you be all right? And you will. And so will your three wonderful children. And your mom will always be guiding you from heaven, and your dad. Your dad, you know, many years ago, before you were ever heard of, do you know something? That your mom and dad one day, they both met each other and they fell in love. Do you know what that is? It's a crazy thing that men and women do. But they fell in love and they promised each other, I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. And you know something? They kept that promise to each other. And because of their great love for you, they brought you into the world. And the love that Mom and Dad expressed for you is what made you who you are today. In other words, your three beautiful, gorgeous children. And you know, baby, do you know why I say that? Because there's a bunch of your friends here today who have come to make you smile and to make you laugh and to tell you, I love you too. And Oisin, and Oren, you have many people today. All they can do is stand and look at you, and they have nothing to say to you. But they want you to know that you are loved. And so in the midst of all the sadness, and you know that Mom was very sick for too long, and nobody wants to be sick. But Jesus has also promised us that I will be with you in sickness and in health all the days of your life. And because your mom was very close to Jesus, Jesus was very close to her. And you know, she looked forward to this day in a strange way. And she was ready to leave this world because she had everything done. And as we heard earlier on, she was a great person for providing for you and that big, big, big sack that you guys brought up. It was only a few days ago that she was shopping for you guys. That was her way of saying, I love you. And so the best thing that you can do is continue to be who you are. And you're like a little plant, and you're just growing, and you're ready to blossom. And so the better you can be, the closer you'll be to your mom, and you'll blossom out, and one day, you will be regarded like your mom, as somebody who wasted no time, who loved everyone, who was kind and productive. And your dad will be to you your role model and your guide. So be nice to him. You know, he's getting old, so be nice to him. So this, for mom, is truly a day of pride, a day of joy, when she can say, look at my kids. They're wonderful, they're beautiful. Cherish that, keep it always in mind. To all of us today, I guess we have to say, what or how has Helena impacted my life, your life? And I think the greatest thing we can say is that she became a role model for so, so many. A role model of wholesome Christian life, Christian living. A life of self-sacrifice. A life of pain and anguish. A life of determination. A life of putting others before herself. A life patterned on the life of Jesus Christ. And today, as we come together, we also want to say to her, thank you, Helena, for your example and for indeed enriching the lives of each and every one of us. And so, Helena, all we can say to you is today is, well done, good and faithful servant. Because you've been faithful in the little things which God has given to you on this earth to do. Now enter into the joys of everlasting life. Do you know, before, if you get a chance today, maybe after the family have left for the crematorium, you might want to take a silent look at the back of the church there, because that beautiful artwork there at the back of the church is in memory of Gerard, who passed through here 21 years ago. Take a look at it, because it speaks a multitude which was chosen as a memorial to him. And every time you guys see that picture at the back, remember your Uncle Gerard, because that picture is of a mom as well. It is the mother of Jesus, who always cares for us. Whenever you look at it, you might say, that is my mom. invite those of you leading us in the prayers that we pray. Please come forward at this time.
We pray in thanksgiving for all the blessings that came to so many people through the life of Helena. May she now receive the fullness of God's blessing in eternity. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Helena touched all our lives. Help us to keep alive the values and the ideals she put before us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all our departed brothers and sisters. Today we pray especially for Helena's brother John. May Helena be reunited with him in God's kingdom, where there's no more pain and suffering. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the family and friends of Helena. In these difficult days, may the Lord be their strength and their consolation. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. As we pray for Helena and her family, we pray especially for Jody. We pray for Ashin, Oren, and Bevin. We pray for Helena's mom and dad, Tom and Mary, for her sisters. We pray for Jody's parents, Brendan and Kathleen. We pray for the many acquaintances and friends who journeyed with Helena through her short life. We pray that they will know in the midst of their sorrow and grief that they will know the comfort, the strength, and the consolation which only God can give. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Father, hear these prayers and the prayers of our hearts. May we know your comforting love and peace today and in the future. We make our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice and prayers may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant Helena, on whose funeral day we offer you the sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to her, or any human fault have affected her, it may by your loving gift be forgiven and wiped away. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful, O Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when the body of our earthly dwelling lies in death, we gain an everlasting dwelling place in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You may sit or kneel, whichever is your custom in your local church or place of worship. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world,
and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, our Bishop, and all the clergy, remember your servant Helena, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. United as members of the one family of God, under the headship of Jesus Christ himself, together we stand and pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to be
introduced to my brother. But only say the word, my soul shall be healed. Those of you receiving Holy Communion, there will be two communion stations up on either side of the casket.
Jesus, good shepherd, call.
you're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. You always made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and God just took the only one I know. So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until
let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Helena, who today has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
This time, Mary, we would like to make some remarks in tribute to Helena's. Please, you are seated already.
Helena was always the talkative one, and I'm sure that she's having a good laugh looking down on me as I deliver this eulogy, and I hope I will do her justice. First of all, on behalf of both families, there are so many people we want to acknowledge and thank at this time. Dr. Billy and Dr. Julie O'Connor, Convent Street Clinic, the Oncology Unit, University Hospital Kerry, Dr. Sheehan and the Palliative Care Team, the nurses who looked after Helena at home, and a special thanks to Nancy from the Irish Cancer Society. We also want to thank Father Jack for coming to visit Helena at home and for the lovely service today. To the undertakers, James Hacknett, thank you for your professionalism and sensitive handling of the arrangements. Tomorrow, Donald, thank you for the beautiful music and singing during the Mass. And finally, to everybody for coming today and to all those who have offered words of support and sympathy, and for honouring Helena's wishes. As it would be impossible to thank everybody individually, please accept our sincere thanks. I have early memories of growing up at home with Helena, and we always had great fun. She was definitely the joker of the family. She always knew how to make us laugh and keep a straight face herself. Helena loved to talk and chat. She loved get-togethers, and going home was always the last thing on her mind. She loved life and enjoyed the crack. Helena was taken too soon from us, but packed so much into her 39 years. She dealt with her illness with grace and good humour. Helena loved to look well and always did. Even in the last fortnight, she had her hair and nails done and had all her appointments booked up to Christmas. She was a wonderful daughter, sister, wife, and above all, a wonderful mother to her three beautiful children, Oisín, Orn, and Baileen. Her children were her world. She simply loved being a mom. She did what she could to protect them from her illness and to keep their lives as normal as possible. She couldn't have done this without the love and support of her husband, Jody. Helena met Jody 20 years ago, and they subsequently got married in Rome. Only 2 weeks ago, Helena told me she truly met her soulmate, and she felt so lucky to have Jody. They were a united and loving couple and doted on their three children. This is a very sad occasion for my mum and dad. They celebrated their 50th wedding anniversary last Thursday, and Helena, being the organiser that she was trying to organise a cake and a little celebration to mark the occasion. She truly was remarkable, and this is only a glimpse of the type of person Helena was. She is now reunited with our brother, Jer. She was the best sister that anyone could ever have, and she was my best friend. Helena, we love you.
Sound like a misnomer, but happy anniversary, Tom and Mary. Jeez, you're old. Like myself. Perhaps you'd like to stand for the final commendation and farewell. Trusting in God, we pray together for Helena. And now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see her again and enjoy her friendship forever. Although we as family and congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joys of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
To
the soul of Helena, your servant, in the sight of this world. She is now dead, but in your sight, she lives forever. Forgive whatever sin she might have committed through a human weakness, and in your goodness, grant her everlasting life and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. May she rest in peace. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Helena, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, again. Again, thank you from the family. It means so much to them beyond words can express at this time. But your very presence and prayers is so meaningful this time. My thanks to Father O'Mahony and Father O'Connor, who can celebrate with us today, have come to assure you of their prayers also. Just one reminder, as you probably know already, the family will be leaving immediately for the crematorium, so there will be no greetings afterwards or expressions of sympathy. They're heading out immediately.
Of the leaves as you walk down the street. She's the smell of certain foods you remember, flowers you pick, the fragrance of life itself. She's the cool hand on your brow when you're not feeling well. She's your breath in the air on a cold winter's day. She's the sound of the rain that lulls you to sleep, the colours of a rainbow. She's Christmas morning. Your mother lives inside your laughter. She's the place you come from, your first home. She's the map you follow with every step you take. She's your first love, your first friend, even your first enemy. But nothing on earth can separate you. Not time, not space, not even death.